Hey everyone, I'm Sam from Professional Music Technology, and in this video we're going to be taking a closer look at the new Boss RC-5 loop station. But before we dive into how it works, let's just quickly run through its key specs to see what's been upgraded from a previous RC-3 model that it's replaced. The RC-5 is a stereo looper housed in Boss's classic compact pedal chassis. It offers up to 13 hours of record time, a pretty major upgrade from the 3 hours that was on the RC-3. Just like that old model, there's 99 memory slots for saving loops and a built-in drum machine for backing rhythms, although the RC-5 now gives you a lot more options in terms of drum sounds and patterns. The display screen has also been upgraded to a bright, crisp, multicoloured LED display, making it easier to see the status of your loop and more intuitive to navigate menus. But probably the most important upgrade over the RC-3 is what's going on under the hood, as the next-gen RC-5 utilises 32-bit processing as opposed to the 16-bit processors of older generation Boss loopers. And this really helps to preserve the audio quality, especially when recording multiple overdubs. Other features include MIDI and external pedal connectivity for added control options. A USB port allows you to back up loops to your computer. There's a loop reverse function, and the pedal can run on either a standard 9-volt power supply or a battery. So we're going to run through a few of the main features, and hopefully if you have just picked yourself up one of these, this demo will also act as a bit of a quick start guide to help you get going with the RC-5. Looking at the layout and connections first, as mentioned a moment ago, the RC-5 is a stereo looper, so there's A and B inputs and outputs for left and right signals, or it can be used in mono with just the A signal path for a standard guitar to amplifier type setup. In terms of controls, the single knob allows you to cycle through the 99 phrase memory patches, or if you press that knob, it will allow you to adjust the volume level of the loop playback. There's two buttons to control the onboard drum machine. One simply toggles the rhythm on and off, and the other adjusts the tempo, either a tap tempo, or you can make fine adjustments using that control knob. The setup button allows you to access settings for things like the display screen, MIDI, and external control pedals. And the memory button is where you need to go to change your looping options, such as the reverse function, or if you want to change drum sounds or patterns. So moving on to actually recording a loop, in its standard out-of-the-box configuration, just like most single switch loopers, pressing the foot switch once will start recording, indicated by a red display screen. Hitting it again will enter play mode, so you can jam over the top, and once more enters orange overdubbing mode. You can press and hold the foot switch to undo the last overdub you recorded. Double tapping it will stop the looper, and if you hold down the switch whilst the looper is stopped, you can delete your loop. If you want to record a loop with a drum backing rhythm, firstly you need to turn on the rhythm section, then press the memory button and navigate to the rhythm submenu, which will then allow you to cycle through different drum kits and patterns, change the time signature, and adjust the rhythm volume and the amount of reverb that's applied to the drums. Now, we're not going to be going into too much depth with all the configuration options available here, but in its default setting, the drum machine on the RC-5 will start playing as soon as you start recording a loop. If you did want a bit more of a count in, however, simply scroll through the rhythm submenu until you reach the page titled Start. If you then change this setting from Loop Start to Before Loop, a single press of the foot switch will now just start the drum machine, so you can get a feel for the tempo and the groove. And the next time you hit that switch will be to start recording, and this really helps to keep your looping sounding tight. The final function that we're going to look at is the loop reverse feature, which is accessed again by pressing the memory button, but this time follow the loop submenu to toggle the reverse on and off. When set to on, your loop will play backwards for a pretty interesting effect, and if you wanted to toggle this on the fly, you can connect an external foot switch to the looper, which is configurable in the control menu. So once you're happy with all of your settings for a particular song, or maybe you want to save the loop that you're working on, the last thing that you need to do is hold down both the setup and memory buttons, which will then allow you to access the utility write menu, where you can then select one of the 99 memory patches to save everything to, so you can come back to it later. So that's how to use all the basic features of the Boss RC-5 loop station. Time to go and get looping. Thanks for watching, I hope you found that helpful. For more information on any of the next generation Boss Looper pedals, visit pmtonline.co.uk, or you can try one out for yourself at your nearest professional music technology store. As always, don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram as PMT House of Rock. And if you enjoyed this video, please do give it a thumbs up. And for more Boss Looper videos, hit that subscribe button and go and check out the channel. Thanks again, I'll see you soon.